The following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, first canto, second chapter, text number 3, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on May 27, 1974, in Rome, Italy.
Let me offer my respectful obeisances unto Him, Shuka, the spiritual master of all sages, the son of Vyasadeva, who, out of his causeless compassion for those gross materialists who struggled to cross over the darkest region of material existence, spoke this Purana, supplement to the Vedas, the cream of Vedic knowledge, after having personally assimilated it by experience.
Trasanubhavam akhilasvitisharamekam adhyatadivam adhititir sadanatamondam संसारिणां करुणायाः पुराणगह्यं संगवैशूनं उपजामि गुरुं मणिना च सूत गोस्वामी इज ऑफरिंग रिस्पेक्ट टू द स्पिरिचुअल मास्टर सुखदेव गोस्वामी व्हेन वी ऑफर रिस्पेक्ट टू द स्पिरिचुअल मास्टर एंड एनी मैन वी ग्लोरीफाई हिज ट्रांसेंडेंटल क्वालिटी. That is glorification. Just like we offer respect to Krishna, we glorify. So, this is very important process. To glorify the spiritual master by his activities, what he is actually doing. That is glorification. So what Sukadeva Goswami did, Sanubhavam. He first of all heard from his father, Vyasadeva, Bhagavad Srimad Bhagavatam, and realized it. He's not a professor and Bhagavad reciter. Just like in India now, there are a class of men, especially in Vrindavan, the Gosai. They make a business. Therefore, there are many, many very artistic Bhagavad reciters. But they could not turn even one man to Krishna consciousness. Because they are not self-realized, sanubhava. And of course, we have tried our best. So in few years, there are so many Krishna conscious persons. This is the secret. Unless one is sanubhava, self-realized, life is Bhagavad, he cannot please Bhagavad. That will not be effective. Gramophone will not help. Therefore, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's secretary, Sarup Damodar, recommended Bhagavata Parogya Bhagavata Sthana. That if you want to read Srimad Bhagavatam, you must approach a person who is live, living Bhagavatam. Bhagavata Parogya, Bhagavata Sthana. Otherwise, there is no question of Bhagavata realization. So, Sukadeva Goswami learned from his father Vyasadeva Mahabhagavata, and he realized it. Sanubhavam. What is this book? Akhila Sutisaram Ekam. Akhila means all, universal. There are many scriptures, many religious scriptures, especially the Vedas. Shruti means Veda. Shruti is learned by hearing, not by reading. You can understand Vedic principle even though you are not illiterate, provided you hear them, oral reception. God has given you the ear. And if you try to hear submissively, to receive something, then it will be fruitful. Submissive. Sritikatam tunumam gyanipriyasam. This is the Brahma realization when he met Krishna. So he said this verse, Jnani Prayasam Udapasa Namanta Eva Namanta Eva Sarvakuritanga Bhavadiya Vata. People who are endeavoring to understand the absolute truth by the dint of his puffed-up knowledge, they'll never be able. They'll never be able. Jnani Prayasam. One has to give up this illegitimate attempt to understand the absolute truth by his personal knowledge. That is not. Krishna is not so cheap thing that by exercising your brain you can manufacture a way to understand Krishna. Krishna said, Naham prakasa sarvasya yoga maya samabhidaha. I am not exposed to everyone. I am covered by yoga maya. People will not be able to understand me. And so many jnanis, yogis, karmis, they cannot understand. No. Then Krishna says, bhaktyabhava vijanati javan jaschamita. Only through devotional service. Devotional service means submission. Surrender. First of all, surrender. Sarvadharman parityajya mamekam saranam. You cannot understand me by your so-called karma, jnana, yoga, dhyana. No. It's not possible. Bhaktyamavi vijanati. Bhakta means to surrender. So, here it is Suti Saram. And this Bhagavata is the Suti Saram, just like cream. You churn the milk, 2 months of milk, you get, say, 5 kg of butter. The Saram, essence. If you simply try to see where is the essence, you have to churn it. Then the milk there is, you can be, you may possess lots of milk. But from the milk you have to take the cream. That is intelligence. The Srimad Bhagavatam is the cream of Vedic knowledge. Therefore it is said that Nigama kalpataru galitam phalamidam. Nigama means Vedas. And kalpataru, Vedas is just like desert tree. Desert tree means whatever you want, you can have it from Vedic knowledge. Just like in India, Ayurveda. Ayurveda means this is material thing, but still it is in the Vedas. Dhanurveda, military science. There are so many Veda. Veda means knowledge. So, the Vedic knowledge is so perfect that anything you want, material or spiritual, you get the knowledge perfect. That is Veda. Veda is not ordinary thing. And it is learned by hearing. Tadvijnanartham sa gurumeva avigacchet srotriyam brahmanishtam. Vedic knowledge, formerly there was no need of books. Nowadays, at the present moment, our memory is not so sharp due to Kali Yuga. Therefore, Vyasadeva wrote in books, in words, because he foresaw that people in this age, they will be dull-headed, restless. Therefore, if they get this knowledge recorded in writing, they may be able to derive some benefit. Otherwise, formerly, Vedic knowledge was never book reading. No. Sruti. Sruti means hearing. This disciple is so powerful that once he hears from the spiritual master, his memory is recorded immediately. This memory, therefore brahmachari record. If you remain brahmachari, then your brain will be so nice that as soon as you hear something, it will be memorized. This is the benefit of brahmachari. And if the students are allowed to be sexually, indulgent, then where is the brain? This is very scientific to remain brahmachari. To understand from the guru by simply by hearing. Once here. So, there was a case, of course, in the one Englishman chastised another Indian by calling him so many ill names, damn rascal, fool, like that. So, he complained in the court that this man has insulted me. So where is the witness? So the witness, the complainant said, there was a Brahmin who was witness. He was taking bath in the Ganges. So he was summoned. The Brahmin was so sharp in memory, he exactly said, just like gramophone record, tape record, whatever he said. He said, I do not know what is the meaning of this, but these words were said. So people were so sharp in memory, that is Brahmin. Once he heard from the spiritual master. Spiritual master is Kshatriya. He has also nicely heard from the spiritual master. Therefore, Vedic knowledge, factually, it is received simply by hearing. There is no necessity of becoming literate. Illiterate doesn't matter. Because it is, after all, received through the oral listening. That which is called Shruti. And Shruti Saram may come. And of all the Vedic literature, Srimad Bhagavatam is the essence. Sri Vyasadeva first of all describes the Vedas in four Vedas and describes further in Upanishad, further in Puranas. The Puranas, some of the rascals say the Puranas are not written by Vyasadeva. They are rascals. Puranas are also explained further, supplemented. Purana means which completes. Another Purana means the very old, historical. So Puranas, they are mentioned, the Vedic instruction through the history. Just like Vedic instruction, Mahabharata is history. But the whole Vedic literature is there, ideally. King, how, kingdom, politics, practically it is politics, but it is based on Vedic literature. And the Bhagavad Gita is introduced in the Mahabharata. So, the Srimad Bhagavatam is the essence of all Vedic literature, Shruti Sarami. This is the only one. You cannot present another. Ekam. If God is one, similarly, to understand Him, there is only one literature, that is Srimad Bhagavatam. Bhagavad Gita is the preliminary study of Srimad Bhagavatam. Shruti Saram Ekam. Shruti Saram Adhyatma Deepam. Adhyatma Deepam means just like Atma, the soul, is within this body. But due to our darkness, knowledge, insufficient knowledge, we cannot understand Atma, Paramatma. We cannot understand. So, in the darkness, as we require a torch light, similarly, Srimad Bhagavatam is just like the torch light. You can see Atma and Paramatma. Advaita Deepam. Deepam means light, lamp. The white is required. Atititir satam. Just like light is required by a person who wants to go through the light, go through the darkness, but go to the light. Suppose here is light and there is tunnel. And in the tunnel you require some light. To go to the other part of the light. Similarly, this world, this material world, is full of darkness. That is the difference between material world and spiritual world. Material world means darkness wherein you cannot understand what is God, what you are. That is material world. They are very busy in this material world, but they do not know where they are going. Actually, they are darkness. The material world is darkness. They are so-called scholars and teachers. They are also in the darkness, and they are leading other people in the darkness. Because it is darkness, therefore we require sunshine, moonshine, and this electricity. As soon as it is covered, the sun is covered, you can experience it is darkness. At night, it is darkness. Actually, it is darkness. But by the grace of Krishna, He has arranged the light. But there is another world where there is no need of natatra vāsate suburja na sasāṅka na pāvaka. There is another world where there is no need of these things, lighting agent, either sunshine or moonshine. But God is so kind that in each and every universe it is full of darkness. Now you see, how brilliant sun is there. This is His kindness. Jasya prabha prabhavatu jagadanya koti. Jakshakshuresha sabita sakalam grahana. Therefore the sun is described as the eye of all the planets. Because we have got very nice good planet, very nice city, Rome, and London or America, this or that, that's all right. But as soon as it is dark, you cannot see anything. The mercy of sunshine, Krishna's mercy is there, therefore you can see, you can enjoy. Therefore sun is described, jatsaksuresa savita, savita means sun, is jatsaksu, savita is actually the eyes. Jatsaksuresa savita, sakalagrahana. Without sunshine you cannot see. In any part of the universe, in any planet, actually the sun is supposed to be the eye. There was one eye, the sun, another eye, the moon, of the Absolute, Virat Rupa. So when He sees, then you can see. Without He seeing, you cannot see. We are very much proud. Can you show me? God, what can you see? That's it. Unless God sees, you cannot see. Why you are so much proud of saying, we have not seen, we have not seen? What you can see? They're so rascal, they have these teeny eyes, they're proud of, they can see God, they can see this thing, they can see. And first of all, understand what you can see without seeing by the God. God sees by the sun, then you can see. Your seeing power is so dependent, and you are so much proud that you can see. Just see how much the whole world is full of rascals. Do they not say, we have not seen God? And what you can see? You cannot see even yourself, and what you will see God? You are seeing your father and mother, and when they die, you are crying, oh, my father has gone. Where he has gone? He is lying here. Why do you say, my father has gone? No, he is gone. What do you mean by gone? The father, you have always seen the body of the father that is lying here. Why do you say? That means you have never seen your father. You have never seen your brother. So this is our position. We cannot see. Still we are proud. Can you show me God? He does not think his incapability, that I cannot see him. Our daily necessities of life without the sunlight. Therefore, here it is said, adhyatma dīpam. It is the light. If you want to see God, then you have to see through this life, and for whom this seeing is necessary. It is not necessary for the ordinary rascals. It is necessary otititirisatanatamundham, one who is sober to think that why you are put into the darkness. We require light, find that unless God gives us the light, sunlight, we are always in night. We cannot see. Tamundham. So those who are intelligent, that why shall I remain in this darkness if there is light, just like in daytime. If there is a dark room, we are staying. And if you hear that why I shall stay in this darkness, there is light, enough sunlight outside, immediately we will be busy. Let me go to the light, why shall I remain in this dark room? Similarly, the sober man, intelligent man, he will think that I am put into this material world which is full of darkness. Is there any light? Where can I go? That is intelligence. Delhi is in the northern part of the hemisphere. In 6 months, no light. So it is intelligence. That why you are discovering so many electricity light? Because we want light. So therefore intelligent person should be that this material world is by nature dark, whether there is another nature where there is only light. Therefore it is said, otititir satanatamundham. This Śrīmad-Bhāgavatam is required for such intelligent person who wants to go out of this darkness to the light. The Vedic information is that tamasi mā jyotirgamā. Don't remain in the darkness. Just go out to the light. Jyotirgamā. Jyoti means light. Vedic injunction is that don't remain in the darkness, go to the light. So when one becomes inquisitive, how to go to the light, for him this Śrīmad-Bhāgavatam. That is said, the otititirisatāṁ. Titirisatāṁ means to surpass, to overcome. Otititirisatāṁ, desiring to overcome. Otititirisatāṁ. Tamundham, this darkness, the position in darkness. Who are in the darkness? Why these people are in the dark? Saṃsārinām. They are undergoing the punishment because they have forgotten Krishna, they have defied the supremacy of Krishna. They are put into the darkness, just like one who defies the laws of the government, they are put into the jail, outlaws. Similarly, Krishna Bhuliyaji Bhagavan, these rascals who have forgotten Krishna, God, to serve Him, and want to remain independent without serving, they are made servant of the prison house, Maya. Just like the criminal. We don't care for government's law, we can do anything, all right, come on here, of course. Slap. Remain here. This is your position. Simply defying, I don't care for God. You may not care, but Maya is there. He'll give you a kick and put you in there. You'll learn how to care. You'll learn how to care. This is the position. These rascals, they have become godless. And suffering day and night, threefold miseries, adhyatmika, adhidoivika, adhibhauti, still they are not coming to their senses. So blunt, so dull-headed, that this is intelligence. When one comes to this understanding that I don't want all these sufferings, why they are forced upon me, then he can become a gentleman. Just in the jail, nobody wants to what is called?
Breaking stone.
He doesn't want, but there is jail superintendent's order. He must break so much. And there is stick. If you don't break, then. So it is going on. Maya is kicking. Always. He must do it. Prakriti kramanani puni karmani. He wanted to eat anything and everything, all right. You take this body of hog and eat soon. That's all. This is my prakriti. He has given you a body. You have to suffer according to the body. Karanam gunasangasya sadasam janma junish. Why there are different types of bodies, different types of enjoyment? Everyone is in the material world. Why one has become hog, one has become dog, and one has become very rich man and demigod? Why? Who is making arrangement? Who wants to become cat and dog? Who does not want to become king? But why this is arrangement? Who is doing this? This rascal cannot understand. Therefore, to cover all this ignorance, they do not believe in the next life. But where from these varieties of life are coming? They have no brain. The so-called scientists, so-called, all bogus theory. Prakriti kramanani, gunai karmani, as you desire, he'll be given the chance by prakriti. Prakriti kramanani, gunai karmani. Ahankara vimuratma karta hamiti vandate. He is thinking that I am independent. Vimura, rascal. Karta, is not karta. When there is death, you do not like to die. Why there is death? Why you are forced to die? What is your scientist will say? Oh, this is natural. But you cannot fight. You do not want to die, but death is forced, and you do not, even though you do not like, you say, hey, it is natural. You cannot explain why death is forced there. Why birth is forced there. Janma mitru jara vyadhi. You do not want to become old man. Why you are forced to become old man? You do not want to have disease. Why you are forced to accept disease? They have no sense. They are so dull-headed. They do not want any solution, but there is solution. Therefore it is called saṃsāriṇām. They are dull-headed, rascals. They are undergoing the nature's process from one life to another, all miserable condition. To get out of this miserable condition, Sukadev says, Kurunaya aha. Kurunaya means out of compassion. People are suffering. This is Vaishnava. Vaishnava takes so much trouble to speak to the rascals and dulls about God consciousness. Why? Out of compassion. They are very compassionate. So many people are suffering for want of knowledge. Let me try to give them some. Kurunaya. This is Vaishnava's qualification. He is very kind. Titik sava karunika. Titik sava karunika. It's like Lord Jesus Christ. He was being crucified. Still he was saying, my father, they do not know what they are doing. Is it not? He's so much compassionate that these rascals do not know what they are doing, rascals. Still, I request you to forgive them. This is Vaishnava. Personally, he is suffering, but he is still compassionate. There was an article recently that Jesus Christ, although he was crucified, he did not die. Yes. He went to Kashmir. Some historical references are there. So, actually, when he was representative of God, son of God, how this rascal could kill him? It was his soul. Anyway, so the devotees, they are so compassionate, they are titiksam, they suffer all kinds of odds in this material world. Still, they try to give the information. There is God, there is kingdom of God, you are suffering here, please do this so that you can again come back to home. But this is the question. Karunaya, out of compassion. Karunaya ha purana guhyam. Purana, there are 18 types of puranas. Out of that, Bhagavat is also purana. This Purana is very confidential. This is not ordinary. It is called spotless. Spotless Purana. Because in this Purana, in this history, or in the supplementary of Vedic knowledge, there is only a description of devotional service. Dharma Prujita, this dharma, this kind religious, the Bhagavat religion, is so perfect that all kinds of cheating types of religion is kicked out from it. Dharma Prujita Kuipo. They are not accepted. All cheating types of religion. There are so many religious, there is not perfect knowledge. In the disobey, they cannot without disobey. Because it cannot train people to the perfection. They remain defective always. Big priests, big cardinals, they simply disobey. Christ says, thou shalt not kill, says, simply eating meat, that's all. No intoxicants, they are taking it. We cannot be trained up. Even those so-called priests, they are not trained up. They cannot take it up. Therefore, Bhagavad principle is so nice that little training, sarpamapiyasya dharmasya trayati mahatuva, little training, even the most fallen can be elevated to the highest position.